Sean.
Stopped. We're going to bring him back, as he said. We're going to bring him back. We're going to deport. Deport. With the help of everyone here tonight, we're going to win Pennsylvania this November. We're going to Paris. And we're going to take back the White House, and we're going to take back our country. We're going to take it back. Our country's been stolen from us. You see that? One of the greatest crimes is what they've done over 4 years and hiding what the obvious facts are. Isn't it? Isn't it a shame? You run for the president of the United States from a basement. All very dishonest stuff, but you know, we're gonna have the greatest election. I tell you what, we did fantastically in 2016. We did much better in 2020. You know, we did much better. And it was rigged. It was a rigged deal, but we did much better. But it's nothing compared to the enthusiasm all over, not just in Pennsylvania, all over. There's nothing compared to the enthusiasm that we've seen over the last year. Because, I mean, a a year. Think of it, a year and a half ago it started. It really started from immediately after the election. You want to know the truth? But a year and a half ago, we were seeing crowds of people desperate to have rallies, desperate to have anything to take back our country. And we're going to take it back. Next week, the Republican Party will hold its convention in Milwaukee, Wisconsin. And 5 days from now, we will officially accept the Republican nomination for president. We're going to get a good senator, I'll tell you. He has a real stiff right now in office. He's just stiff. You know, your current senator, I never met him. I don't think I've ever met him. I was only there 4 years, but I don't think I ever met him. I'll tell you, that's your senator. He votes with Biden or whoever happens to be furthest left. We gotta get him elected. McCormick. We gotta get McCormick, President McCormick. A good man, too. He's a valiant fighter. He's a great, great gentleman. So we're gonna bring him up for can we bring him up for a couple of minutes later? All right. You get ready, McCormick. You get ready. I'll get you up here. The world will see a vibrant Republican Party that is bigger, stronger, more confident, and more united than ever before. That's what we are. We're the most united party now. You know, I'm watching the fake news go crazy because they say the Republican Party has not been united since Ronald Reagan like it is right now. It was united under Ronald Reagan the second time. It was very united. And they said there's never been anything like it. They've never seen a movement like this. Make America great again. You know, Joe Biden talks about, we have to stop MAGA. MAGA means make America great again. That's all they want to do. If he was doing his job, I wouldn't even be doing this. I'd be at some beautiful place with a gorgeous ocean, the Mediterranean, the Atlantic, maybe the Pacific. Thank you. To get a senator elected and to make sure we take back the White House, because if we do, we're going to make America better than ever before. We're going to make it. And it's not easy, because we have millions and millions of people in our country that shouldn't be here. Dangerous people. Criminals. We have criminals. We have drug dealers. We have people that should not be here. And it's much tougher than if it happened at the, you know, we had the strongest border ever. In recorded history, we had the best border. In fact, if they could ever put up a chart, I don't know if they could do it. Do you guys have access to that chart that I love so much? You don't mind if I go off teleprompter, do you? Because these teleprompters are so damn boring, I try and explain it. Oh, there's a, wow. You guys are doing it. They're getting better with time. My guys, take a look at that chart. Take a look at the arrow on the bottom. See the big red arrow, right? So that's when I left office. That was the lowest point, and that comes right from the government services, comes right out of Border Patrol. Take a look at that. So that arrow is the lowest amount of illegal immigration ever in recorded history into our country. And then the worst president in the history of our country took over. And look what happened to our country. Probably 20 million people. And you know, that's a little bit old, that chart. That chart's a couple of months old. And if you want to really see something that said, take a look at what happened.